Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to one of the more interesting videos that I've done yet. So a few days ago, my friend Mark, who you may remember from one of my videos last year, suggested that I, along with some other friends, participate in a breakdance battle. I haven't danced in a while, and I wasn't all that great even when I tried. And besides, I'm a classical anime pianist, not a b-boy, so I'd be really out of my element. But after giving it some thought, I decided to give it a go, and so this is what happens when a classical pianist tries breakdancing. We're going to be competing in Rhythmic Damage, which is a yearly jam hosted by Freaks of the Beat, which is the breakdance group at the University of Pennsylvania. I participated once a few years back as a student, so I'm pretty familiar with the 4v4 crew battle format. But we have a few issues. One, the last time we battled, my crew got completely wiped. Two, to make matters worse, I haven't practiced in years. Three, I am literally the least experienced member on our crew this time around. And four, my cardio is awful and I have zero flexibility. Not to mention, pros like B-Boy Balm, Ills, and B-Girl Ami will be there to compete and adjudicate the event. So yeah, I'm screwed. But here's the plan. I'm going to practice almost every day for about an hour a day for the next week to get ready for the event. I'll try to relearn most of my previous moves, put them together, get some of my flow back, and maybe even develop a little bit of musicality. Needless to say, I think I'm going to be very tired and very sore by the end of this week. But it'll be fun, I hope. So yeah, this is basically a room that I have downstairs from where I live. And so I'll be doing probably most of my practicing here since I don't have another readily accessible space to me. We also have this speaker column thing, which will be cool. And I think that'll help me out and hopefully not annoy the neighbors too much. But yeah, let's get to practicing. I also gotta wear one of these so my glasses don't fall off.
And so, day one began. The goal was to get back some of my old repertoire and regain some of the musicality needed to dance. Now, I'll be the first to say that just because I'm a musician, that doesn't mean that I can dance. To me, the way the musicality works in both is very different. When I'm playing the piano, I am producing the musicality in the sense that I get to dictate how the music moves and how it flows. When I dance, the music controls my musicality. I don't get to choose how certain things move, and instead I move in response to music, which feels very weird. In fact, for most of my b-boying career, if you can call it that, I've always struggled to feel the beat and hit things on time. And needless to say, things weren't much different this time around. I start off with a quick warm-up, some jumping jacks, some walking to the beat to loosen up and feel the music, and some top rocking. Then it was on to stretches, where I was reminded yet again of how inflexible I am. I know some people say to not do static stretches during warm-up, but I feel like I need to have that sort of range of motion when I'm breaking, so I do them for this application.
It was pretty bad. You're already sweating. I'm like tired after just the warm-up.
After warm-up, it's time to work. Now, breakdancing is comprised of four main components. Top rocks, footwork, freezes, and power. Top rocks are what you do while standing. People use this to feel the beat and get into their set, and also as a way to add different levels or heights to their dance. Footwork is what you do on the floor with different steps and movements, and tends to be a bit more technical. This can also include flows and threads. Freezes are holds or poses they hit on beats or to end your set. And finally, power is all the momentum-based movements that you probably think of when you hear the word breakdancing. Needless to say, I probably won't be able to learn any power in 1 week. I started with a quick set to see how my flow felt. Not too bad, but definitely need some work. So I drilled some basic footwork patterns, the six step, CCs, and kickouts, and worked on some freezes. I tried a tiny bit of power. Definitely decided that it was a no-go. And I fell. A lot. And hit one or two cool things. But I still closed with two last sets of freestyle to try to put everything together. It wasn't the worst thing in the world, but I still have a lot of work left to do.
It's pretty bad. I'm like sweating like crazy. My heart rate is very high. It's been like an hour, a little bit more I would say. And I don't feel like I did all that much. I couldn't even land a shoulder freeze. Power is definitely out of the equation. Oh my gosh, we have our work cut out ahead of us. So stretching, we'll call it a day. Day two. Basically, my whole body is kind of sore, like my chest, my shoulders, a little bit of my forearm and wrist, my back from like the twisting, and like a little bit of my abdomen. Even my legs feel a little bit weird because I don't move like this very often. Honestly, it could be worse. I expected everything to be in like extreme pain, but it's just a little bit discomfort, like post-workout soreness. So we'll see how today goes.
Day two, honestly, wasn't much better than day one. I started with basically the same format with the stretching and warm-up, but I quickly realized I was feeling a lot worse than I originally thought. I did get some good progress on some footwork drills. And even practiced a new combo. Still no windmills though. Oh, and a lot of falling. That's going to be a common theme in this video.
My body just feels much more tired today. I don't want to be sick, but I keep pushing too hard. So I feel like I'm getting nothing done. It's gonna have to be a shorter day.
And that's why I spent a good chunk of time lying on the floor. Day three introduced the first big change to my practicing routine.
So today we have a special sort of thing where I get to practice with Eddie, the one and only. It's not our first rodeo. We've done this before, right?
It's true. Yeah. It's mine. Famous YouTube star.
I mean, you're better than me at this point, right?
I don't know. It's tough to say.
Because we were about the same, but then like I stopped and you kept doing it.
Yeah, but did I really get better? That's the real question.
We're reliving our first rhythmic damage, or your second rhythmic damage, because we competed then, and yeah, we got wiped, because we were baby freaks.
I only competed maybe that year with you. So you lost in the prelims this year, hopefully we won't.
We're gonna make it through the top 16.
Caleb Watt says, oh wait.
Six.
Cool, we'll win next year.
Hey, it's 4 years late,
Practicing with someone else makes you a lot more self-conscious of what you're doing, but it's also a lot more fun. Eddie and I took turns doing rounds and trying out different transitions and ideas. We also worked on combos and developing character and musicality.
What's up?
This is the main TV. Identity crisis.
The B-boy identity crisis. When you hear Frog Boogie playing, what part of your identity comes out? What do you want to say to me? Speak to me through your dance.
Contemplating. I lied.
You're just pondering.
Oh.
Miss. Recover. Yeah. Oh, do the other shoulder. Recover.
Oh. Let's
go. Those weren't crashes. Those were transitions.
And of course, at the end, we had to battle it out.
Let the viewers decide who wins. Two rounds.
Get in on the gear up.
Yeah, gear up for the battle.
In case you're not familiar, this is what usually happens at the beginning of breaking tournaments where both teams just wait for the other person to get up.
At some point, you gotta look at the audience and be like.
And then the MC starts being like,
go, go, go!
So, this is good stuff, Eddie. I hope you're ready for Saturday.
Only if you are.
Only if I am? Right, guys, because I have to get us in before you have a shot.
That's right. All right. Okay, but if you don't see me dancing at the competition,
it's my fault. It's my fault.
On day four, I mixed up my routine again.
And so for today, I figured I'd go to Freaks of the Beats compass session, which I think is happening on Penn's campus. What it is basically Penn in the middle of their campus has a compass, and so freaks will go and cipher every once in a while just to practice, and I think they might be flyering today, so I figured it might be nice to stop by, see if it's happening, and to get a little bit of practice in, just so that I can be with some people and get smoked. So let's head out.
It's been a while since I've been back to Freaks, so I basically didn't know anyone there. It's always a bit nerve-wracking to practice with others, especially when they're more advanced than you, but it's a good way to get inspiration and to break the ice to dance in front of other people. Just finished the session. It was pretty fun. I got some new ideas and some practicing ahead of me. So I guess it's time to head home and do stuff. Day five contained another surprise.
It is indeed. But this is day five and we have a special guest with us.
Let's go.
Samuel. Sam's crew smoked ours 4 years ago. The rhythmic damage. So Eddie and I are out for blood. But unfortunately, Eddie's not here today.
Boo.
And Sam's not competing. So,
because I practiced for 5 days straight, my body was starting to give out on me. And this session ended up being pretty unproductive and much shorter than the others.
Shot. Sam is guest.
It's our drinks right now.
I don't think I'm allowed to say that, but yeah, I think tomorrow's a day off because my body's dead and my shoulder hurts. Oh. And Sam is tired.
I'm so tired.
It's been too long. So it's day six and feeling very tired. My whole body is like kind of hurting. I don't think you're supposed to feel sore in the same spots for 6 days straight. But unfortunately, I don't think I'll have much time to practice tomorrow. So it's like, I either have to practice a little bit today or not practice for 2 days, which is a little bit suspect since the competition's coming up on Sunday. I'll probably just work on a few combos or something like that and call it a day. I may or may not record, probably won't because I'm tired, but yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Spoiler alert, I didn't practice for 2 days, which then brings us to the day of the competition.
We're going to win. No, I'm feeling pretty nervous. It's very different than like playing piano, you know? Because it's like when I'm playing piano, it feels like I have something prepared and I'm ready. But like breakdancing is like so off the cuff. So I'm like, oh, I don't know what to expect. So it's very different. I'm gonna say Caleb Watt.
Caleb Watt.
There it is. Poggers. I'm starting to feel pretty nervous. The lack of practice in the past 2 days is feeling something. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, I felt completely out of my element and totally unprepared.
Heck yeah.
Like, what am I doing? Feels so whack.
You really shouldn't say that to yourself right before
you
come.
You know what? I'm claiming hot stuff.
Our crew, Overflow, made up of Eddie, Mark, and Dale, assembled, and we got ready to compete.
Four rounds per crew for the prelims. Four rounds per crew.
Wait, Eddie!
Virtuoso, man.
Shit!
I gotta practice.
Who's about it? Raise your hand.
We quickly warmed up before the battle in a cipher. And then it was time.
Overflow, raise your hands. On the left, Cipher Syndicate. On the right. Thank you. Dynamic Rockers. C Gang and Dynamic Rockers on deck. Yeah, these guys. These are Illadelphia.
That was okay. Like, I was so shaky when I held the freeze. I felt myself shaking. And I was like,
raise your hand right now. All 150.
Thanks.
That's Illadelphia.
Appreciate it.
We gathered around to watch the set afterwards. It was pretty interesting to see everything right after it happened. The format of the competition got changed from a top 16 to a top 8, so we unfortunately didn't make it in.
Eddie, how do you feel?
It was a lot of fun. I'm glad I got to battle. I don't know if we made top 16.
Yeah, nah, unfortunately it got changed to top 8.
But hey,
so
we'll never know.
We'll never know.
We could have been ninth.
We could have been ninth.
But I'm glad I got to battle. It was fun.
Are you going to get back into it, Eddie?
Yeah. Who knows? Only time will tell.
The people who carried us. Shoulders are hurting from carrying. Big Dong, how'd we do?
I think we did pretty good. There's top 16. I'm pretty confident we would have made it. I think everyone was, other than me, was very crisp, very clean. Pulled off moves that they knew. Eddie pulled out some swipes, you know. Caleb showed some swag, and Dale was his normal
you
self.
You showed
every
some
time.
Swag?
No, I see you showed some swag. Yeah. We really showed up to Cypher Syndicate. They lost in top 8. We never lost in top 8. Come on.
Yeah, we don't lose in top 8.
Yeah, dude. We didn't lose at all, actually, if you think about it.
We just got eliminated.
I don't think of that way. We just, you know, weren't chosen.
We weren't selected.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
They have to let the underdogs play a little.
Yeah.
No, I just thought it was a lot of fun. And I'm really thankful that, like, we all got to just get together and just do this spontaneously. Yeah, it was great.
I just got home. Overall, it was a pretty good experience. I think I had a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun to battle. I think it took, like, about one round to get the nerves out of my system. Unfortunately, that was the only round we had, but it was fun nonetheless. Who knows, maybe I'll keep it up in the future and go to a few jams. And if I go to jams, I'll keep you guys posted. And maybe do videos of those as well. So we'll see. I'm actually so grateful that I agreed to do this and dip my toes back into dance. As a classical and anime pianist, I feel like the music that I interact with is frequently very polished and very refined, and for sure under my control. But with breakdance, everything feels much more raw, aggressive, and even funky in its own way. And that's not even getting into the hip-hop culture that's formed around it and feeds into its every aspect. Being able to dance again reminded me of how there are so many ways to engage with music and to express yourself, and also how every musical experience you have can influence all the other musical things that you're trying to do in the rest of your life. And seeing up close and personal b-boys and b-girls who have made this art form their passion has, in its own way, inspired me to continue with my endeavors on the piano. So yeah, I'm glad I'm able to share this experience with you all, and I hope that you found it interesting. Let me know if you enjoyed this type of video down in the comments below, and until next time, everybody, peace. I can't believe got judged by Ami. Like, a massive fan. We'll win next year.